Ranger's glitter is available in a number of formats, and today we're going to work with the dry fine version. At present, there are 24 colors in the line, and I'll show you some techniques that will allow you to introduce glitter into your art. You can go full bore and sparkle like mad, or try for a more subtle look with just flickers of color. Perhaps you don't think of yourself as an all-out glitter girl, preferring instead to have your glitter a little bit more subtle and perhaps for there to be a little bit less of it. Well, I can do that too, and that's where I thought we would start today, just so that you know you don't have to go totally glittered. You can still get some really great effects, very subtle effects, with just a little bit of glitter. So I'm going to start by using this is Sakura's Quickie Glue Pen, and it works like every other ballpoint pen except that it dispenses glue in a nice fine line. Now this is Stickles Dry Fine Glitter in the color yellow, and if I hold this piece up, now this is from Tim's Wallflower paper pad. It's actually a 12 by 12, but some of the sheets contain the designs reduced to a 6 by 6 design. And you can see that I've used some yellow glitter around these flowers, and you can see the glimmer on there, but it's certainly quite subtle. It's a very small, isolated area. Now I've started to do the same thing on this one. I've worked on these skeleton leaves, and I put just a little bit of glitter on the body of this bird, and I'm going to show you that now with the second bird. This time I'm going to use the color platinum. Now one of the things that you'll notice when you get your jars of the dry glitter is that first of all you can lift this up and there's a shaker top on the top, included in the top rather. Now before you can use that you actually have to take the top off, and again you have to kind of pop this back and grab someplace here. I have a toothpick. Grab a toothpick, push it through the shaker opening, and you can just pop that inner liner out, and that will get it out of your way. So now when you take the top, you lift the top on the shaker, you can actually dispense the glitter through there. So that just gives you a chance to put it out in a little bit more controlled fashion. So what I'm going to do, let me just turn this toward me, I'm going to use the pen, and I'm just going to, rather than outline like I did here on these skeleton leaves, I'm just going to put some little dots of glitter, just some highlights on the bird so that he's got a little bit of glimmer without being totally over the top. So I'll put just some dashes of the glue on his body and perhaps down on his tail a little bit, maybe along here on his wing, and then perhaps just a little bit on his cheek and on his beak. So he's got just this little bit going on. Now you have to move reasonably quickly because the glue will dry. So I like to catch my excess glitter on a scratch piece of paper like this. It's easier to get it back in the jar if you do it this way. So I don't need much because I haven't done all that much on here, and that's probably more than enough. I'm just going to shake it around, and I'm going to actually tap it quite hard to get the excess glitter off. I'm going to actually blow on it too. And you can see just these subtle little hints of glitter on here. So again, glitter doesn't have to be in your face. If you find that you like it, but in smaller doses, this is a really easy way to accomplish that. And you can work on surfaces other than paper. Let me just bring this other one in here for a second. These are from Tim's new Vellum Ephemera Packs, and these are from the Thrift Shop collection. There's these wonderful, all these old ads and these really great giant moths. So this time, rather than use the platinum, I'm going to use, this color is called cinnamon, and it works really nicely on these sepia-toned things. Again, very subtle, it does not have to be in your face. Whoops, I need to take the inner lining out of this one too. Just pop that out. Alright, put this back on. So again, I can just choose to accent some things here on the butterfly, so maybe, or the moth. So maybe what I'll do is just outline some of the elements in the wing. And I'm going to come over here and do the same thing. And again, this glue works perfectly well on the vellum. You can do lots of different things with this, which I really like. It's a nice multi-surface glue that allows you to get glitter, or glue, depending on what you're trying to do, in lots of different places. Again, I'm just going to sprinkle a little bit of the cinnamon color on here because I don't need to actually cover all that much. I'm going to give it a good flick. And again, you can see there's just a little bit of glitter. Now, that's probably a little bit odd, just that those two sections right here. So I might put some up here along the top and perhaps some on top on his antenna, rather. And that will give it a little bit more balanced look. But you can see that there's lots of different ways that you can get glitter on in a very subtle fashion. If you are, in fact, a glitter girl, I think you're going to really like this technique. What I've done is I've assembled some colors that I like, that I know will work together. So I have lavender, this is eucalyptus, waterfall, and lagoon. I'm going to put these together on some score tape, and I'm going to create some self-adhesive glitter stickers, and it'll make more sense as we go along. So what I like to do is use the 2.5 inch wide score tape, and I generally cut pieces, you know, in the 8 or 9 inch range, and I actually store them in Ziploc bags. And when I do these, I typically will do a bunch of this at once. I really enjoy it. I find it's kind of therapeutic some of the time. But before I get started, what I'm going to do is bring in, rather than the nonstick craft sheet that covers my entire work table, I'm going to bring in a loose piece because I want to be able to clean this glitter up with some ease. So once I get this through sticking to my fingers, what I like to do is take different colors of glitter and I'm going to put it on the adhesive side of the score tape, and that will leave me with something that looks like, let me just grab one of these, that will leave me with something, whoops, that's not a good one, let me find a better one, with something that looks like this, that has glitter all over it, and it's score tape with the release paper on the back, and I'm going to show you how I use this, but first we actually have to get it done. So all I'm going to do is start sprinkling colors of glitter on here. Now for something like this, I'm going to just dump this out of the bottle. I'm not going to bother with the shaker top, it's faster this way. And all I'm going to do is put colors on here in whatever arrangement I think looks good. It doesn't have to be anything in particular, because you're going to see that these will be very random when it comes time to use them. So however these go on, they go on. You don't have to worry about blending colors or anything like that. This just works. It's super simple. It's glittery as heck. You make quite a mess. I mean, you end up covered in glitter, but at the end of the day, I love glitter, so it really doesn't matter. I've got this one really dark color in Lagoon. And ultimately, all I want to do is make certain that I've got most of my score tape covered to start with. I think I'm going to add a little bit more eucalyptus. There's not quite enough in there. So I'm going to have this all covered, and then I'm going to burnish this with my fingers. I'm going to rub it really, really hard, and there's a couple of different ways to do this, but I'm just going to start with my fingers initially. Now you can see that there's going to be some glitter left over, and I would never throw this away. I'll come back with another piece of score tape and just pick it all up. So very little goes to waste here. But what I'm going to do is burnish this glitter in here with my fingers so I get this really cool multicolored tape that I can then cut out in various ways. Now, if you're a little squeamish and you don't want to get covered with glitter, what you can do, this is an old piece of, again, nonstick craft sheet that I accidentally cut, so I ended up with this small sheet. And what you can do is just come down here. You can either burnish this with your fingers, you can use a bone folder. There's lots of different ways to accomplish this. Quite honestly, I don't mind the glitter. I enjoy getting into and doing what I'm doing. So you end up, again, with this multicolored thing, and you can kind of put this together however you want. So let's just get the nonstick craft sheet out of the way for 1 second. And ordinarily, I'll be honest with you, I would take this outside and I would flick all the excess glitter off. It helps save some of the mess from in the house or in my studio. Let me just get rid of this in such a way that it won't end up on the floor. But I don't want to go to the door right now and do that. So instead, what I have is this. Now, how can you use this? Well, you can use it with punches and all different kinds of things. I have a variety of punches that I use regularly for various things. And you can even use it with your standard quarter-inch hole punch. So let me show you. Let's start with this flower because it's cool. Now, what you can do is you turn this over. You can see the business end of the cutter is right here, and you can see where that's going to cut. So what I like to do is put the glitter tape through here. I can see what colors are going to be in my flower, and this is the reason I like to use multiple colors on one piece, because it allows me the freedom. Now I can choose to punch this wherever I want, and I can include whatever colors I want. So I can get some that span the blue and the waterfall, or I can get some that are mostly purple. Again, there's lots of different ways that you can do this. That one just got stuck, so that's fine. Most of the time, that's not a problem. And you can see you get these really cool glitter shapes. You can even do circles. Now, let me bring in, again, this is some other colors, but again, the same thing. This is a half-inch circle punch. Really easy to get all these wonderfully colored glitter punches. And in a second, I'm going to bring in some art cards, because, of course, they are my latest obsession. Here's a one-inch hole punch, or one-inch, rather, circle punch. You'll see that even using things like art cards, you can do all kinds of fun things with these glitters. And in fact, again, let's come back. I don't throw anything away. All these little pieces, I save this. As long as I can get a quarter inch hole punch in there, I know, let's see if I can get that to pop through. I know that I can go ahead and use this. And again, it's little, but boy, it's powerful because it's all that wonderful glitter and it can make a really effective embellishment. Okay, so you've seen the basics. You've seen how you make this and then the kinds of ways that you can punch it. So let me just grab a piece of, well, I don't have any paper towel handy, so let's just do this and kind of pull this out of the way for 1 second. And let me bring in some art cards. All of these have some sort of a punched glitter piece on them. And I'm going to just show them to you one at a time here in 1 second. So this one, just the centers. This is, I want to say, this is probably a half inch hole punch, or maybe it's 3/4. It looks, this is a half and it looks a little bit bigger than this. But you see, it gives you some really cool glitter. Now this is done with stickles, but it's hard to make a perfect circle with stickles. But when you punch it like this, you certainly can. So there's one example. Let's see what we have here. These are just 1/4 inch, from my 1/4 inch hole punch, these are 1/4 inch circles. I just use this to make, well, I don't know where it went. It's floating around here someplace. To make one of these little ones, and that's all these are. And then I just circled around it with a pit pen. These are these wonderful little flowers. So all you have to do, now this is picky, admittedly, but I think it's worth it. So all you have to do is just go ahead and roll the score tape off the backing. And you have to be gentle when you do this. You pull it off like this. And you have this wonderful little self-adhesive flower that you can pretty much put anywhere. In fact, let me just bring this in. Now I'm going to talk about this in 1 second, but all you have to do is put this in place, and just like magic, you have this wonderful flower-shaped or circle-shaped, regardless of size, embellishment. Now, glitter is basically a non-porous surface, which means if you use something like Stazon, you can stamp on it. So this is a piece that I made that has, this is the color of glitter that's called Stardust. It's kind of this multicolor shimmery stuff. Diamond tends to be a little bit more yellowy glimmery, and you'll see these when you actually hold them in your hand. This is Stardust, and this is Diamond. So I did this with Stardust, and all I did was take, this is one of our new Joggle stamps. This is the leaf number 1, which I don't have in front of me. I can't put my hands on. But what I've done is I've taken, this is a scribble flower, and this happens to be scribble flower number 2. So all you have to do is grab you some Stazon or some archival ink. It's got to be something that will work on a non-porous surface. Now this works better on light colors, so I would stick with something like the yellow or either the Stardust or the Diamond. You go ahead and you stamp it on there, and now what you have is a self-adhesive piece of glitter in an entirely different shape. So if I wanted to spend a few minutes and I wanted to fussy cut this, I absolutely could. Now, the thing to bear in mind before I go ahead and cut this out all the way, you can cut it out right close to the petals, or you can cut it out with a little bit of a border like I'm doing, but the thing to bear in mind is that score tape is transparent. So you can see that even though I stamped with this leaf, where there's white underneath, you can see the white, but where this green was, you can see the color underneath. So if you want this to be solid, what you would do would be to cut this out, peel it off, and put it on a piece of white paper, whether it's cardstock or something along those lines, and then you would cut that out, and then you'd actually have to glue it because you'd already have put the adhesive on something. But you can do all kinds of really cool things, whether it's just doing punch-outs or then going ahead and stamping and cutting. Lots and lots of really fun ways for those of us that really love glitter. As you probably know, gel medium makes a really good adhesive, and the best part is that this is a matte finish and it dries clear, which means that the adhesive itself is not only not going to show because it's clear, it's not going to be reflective because it's matte. So you can do all kinds of fun things with that. Let's start by just going ahead and adding a little bit of pizzazz to these plain old paper flowers. All I'm going to do is take a little bit of, this is Dina Wakely's gel medium, I'm just going to put a little bit out here. I'm actually going to use the rest of this, even though it looks like far too much. So all I'm going to do is just dab some around the edges of this flower. Now, you can be as glittery as you want with this. If you want subtle, you can go that way. If you want to go into full glitter girl mode, then by all means, go into full glitter girl mode. You're not going to hear me try to dissuade you. And then it's just a question of, let me just bring in something to catch the glitter. Then it's just a question of taking your glitter. Now, I'm using Diamond. This is the whitish clear glitter that has a little bit of gold overtone. There's no gold glitter in it, but that's the color of the sparkles. I don't know if I've taken the inside out on this one. I haven't, so I'm going to actually have to shake this right from the inside. Or you know what I might do? I might just take this and dunk it in the container. That probably makes a little bit more sense. So I'm going to grab my tweezers and then just pull this out. Go ahead and tap the excess off. And whoops, when I turn this over, you can see, and this is the nice thing about using these clear glitters. They let you see the color behind them, but they're going to shimmer with their, in this case, it's kind of that gold tone or that yellow tone. Works beautifully with this. And I could do the same thing with the medium and the light versions of these flowers, but you don't need to see me do that twice. There's other fun things that we can do instead. So let me kind of slide this out of the way. Now, gel medium works as an adhesive, but you can also spread it in a really thin layer and use it like a glue pad. You don't have to have a special glue pad for this. I'm going to show you how easy it is to just go ahead and do this. Now, this is one of our new stamps. This is Wonky House number 3, I believe. All I'm going to do, you can see that there's black on here. A tiny bit of that is going to transfer, but it's not going to matter because I'm going to come back with, let's see. I'm going to come back with the cinnamon. So even if there's a little bit of the black that transfers, it's not going to make any difference. But what I have to do, I have to have water ready. What I'm going to do is put some water right here on my nonstick craft sheet, because the moment I take this off the paper after I've stamped it, I'm going to put it right in water. I don't want the gel medium to dry on here. So that's what I'm going to do. Let's get the glitter off the paper to start with. And all I'm going to do is spread the gel medium out into a reasonably thin layer so it's kind of even on my nonstick craft sheet. And then I'm going to stamp in it. Now this is probably not quite as big as the stamp, so I'm just going to move the stamp around. I'm going to go ahead and stamp this, and I'm immediately going to peel that off the acrylic block and go ahead and put it in the water that I put down there a moment ago. And then I'm going to just put a little bit of the cinnamon out. And you'll see, let me just bring in my catch-all sheet here, you'll see the house begin to emerge as the glitter adheres to the gel medium. Isn't this cool? Now, I probably didn't stamp as well or ink this as well with the gel medium as I could have, which is why it might be a little bit thin down here. But again, nothing ever needs to be perfect in my world. And if I needed to, I could come back with the glue pen and I could just very lightly touch this up, so you know, you can repair that. So that's one thing that you can do. Now let me just bring in another one of the stamps. I'm going to do this one in a different color because this is the leaf stalk. So I'm going to stamp that kind of on the same piece of paper here, but let's find a little bit more interesting color for this leaf. Let's see what we've got here. You know what, I think I'll use eucalyptus. That's a good color for a leaf. So again, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm just going to get this spread out. If this had started to dry up a little bit, I could spritz it ever so lightly with water, but it's not at this point. It hasn't been sitting here long enough. So this time I'm going to make a better effort to fully ink my stamp with the gel medium. I'm going to go ahead and stamp it. This is just 90-pound watercolor paper. I find it very useful. I'm going to get that stamp in the water. I know you can't see it, but you'll have to believe me when I tell you that it's there. And then I'm going to bring in, what am I doing with that eucalyptus? I'm going to bring in the eucalyptus, and I'm just going to go ahead and stamp this. Now, you can do this with any stamp that you have, whether it's one of ours, or a Dilutions, Dina Wakely stamp, anything that you want to do, and this is a perfectly great way to do it. Now, the nice thing is that gel medium dries permanently. It's not going to lift, so here comes the even better part. Let me just get this out of the way. I'm going to wipe up this gel medium, and I want to bring you in something that I already had prepped and ready to go. Grab some paper towel. Gel medium cleans up with water, so it's really easy. Just get that done. All right, so here are some that I had done previously. Now, this is Loretta. Again, these are our new stamps, and you can see that I've stamped her in the gel medium, and then I came back and put some turquoise glitter on. This is lime green. This is Horace. This is Sam done again in the cinnamon, and then this is Mickey done in the black. And so here you go. Here come all your great color choices. These are Dilutions and Color Wash that I have in Tim's Detail water brushes. And I pretty much have luxed myself out here. I have some of everything. I have all the colors in these, which means I have lots of different choices when it comes time and I want to do some coloring like this. So I'm just going to grab some green and some blue, and I'm going to work with Horace because I've already done him in green, but that doesn't mean I'm only limited to green. It just means that I'm going to start with some green, and then I'll probably add some turquoise or some blue and just give him some other color. So this is London Blue. Let's just come in and put a little bit of this in here. Now what I need to do is grab my water brush that's just water, and then I can start blending this out a little bit once I get the plain water flowing. And that just allows me to blend some color like this. If I wanted to, I could dry this, and once it was dry, I could come back and I could kind of put some spots in here. But, you know, the glue is not going to move if you get it wet, because again, gel medium dries permanently. So it affords you the opportunity to come in and to do all your usual kinds of painting or coloring things with your water brushes or however you do this, whether it's with watercolors or, you know, another transparent media, and you get all these really cool effects. I think I'm going to cut these out. I'll use them on an art card. I will, in fact, I have an art card here someplace. I'll take a photograph of it. It's one that I used with a couple of these that I glittered. And you know, it works out really well. You can do all these really fun things and you get this great glittered effect. I want to finish today by showing you a combination of a couple of different things. You can see that I've done some stamping with gel medium and I've glittered it. I've got a couple of pieces here. And this piece right here, this is an art card that I started a while ago, and it's a little difficult for me to actually get you to be able to see the dimension, but I've used Ranger's texture paste on here to create some raised areas that I put glitter on. Now I will say that this works for the texture paste. If you wanted to glob gel medium on, it would work with that as well. It works on anything like this, whether it's a golden gel or medium or a Liquitex product. It'll work on anything like this that's designed to provide some texture or that you can mound up, and what you get are some three-dimensional effects, and then you can combine them with the stamped image, which was kind of my plan for these art cards. So I started by playing with the texture paste and I put some around the perimeter of this art card, and then I dropped some of the eucalyptus and lime colors on here, and then I had some leftover on that catch piece of paper that also had some of the cinnamon color, so I dumped all of that on here, and you get this really interesting blend of colors. And it was that mix of three that I went ahead and used, because again, it's just leftover on that sheet and I don't want to throw it away without actually using up some of it. And that's what I did with this is the leaf stalk, and I stamped this with gel medium and then came back and just took, again, I've got all of this that's accumulated on here that I'm using. So let me show you, I just showed you how you can stamp, so I'm not going to show you that, but I do want to show you how you can use something like Ranger's texture medium, and all I'm going to do is just create kind of a dimensional border with the texture medium, with the texture paste. So I'm just going to use, it's very light, very fluffy, it kind of looks like Cool Whip, although it's a little heavier feeling when you actually go to take it out. I'm just going to use, this is one of Dina Wakely's palette knives, so all I want to do is just kind of put a little bit on here very randomly. I don't want super thick dimension, so I'm not going to spread it on really heavily, and I'm going to just kind of taper it down, and it doesn't have to be anything special. All I'm doing is playing. If this doesn't work, I can toss this. I'm not going to worry about it, but this is how you figure stuff out, is by experimenting and playing. So I'm just going to take a little bit of the texture paste and just kind of drag it along here, and then I'm going to drop some glitter on it and see what it looks like. If it doesn't look great, then so be it, but I think I'm going to like it because I like the first one that I did. So I'm just, again, just going to finish up by taking some of this off here, and the texture paste is going to dry clear, so that means all I'm going to see is the glitter. Let me just close this up. Again, I have all of this mix of color that will work really well with this, so I'm just going to take this and dump this on my art card. This is the vellum surface. It's the one that I really find myself using all the time. That other one happened to be a piece of watercolor, one of the Strathmore artist tiles, but for the most part, I typically lean toward the Bristol vellum. Now, I haven't finished all the way around here, so I can do one of two things. I can either pick this up and dump this back on, or, and again, I'm going to give this a good flick to knock the excess off, or I can come and I can drop some more color on. So let's pick up some of the lighter eucalyptus color. I like this color. And I'm just going to drop some in here. Now there's a limit. This will only absorb so much, or so only so much can actually stick to it. But you know, you play with this, you get some sense about what you can do with it. So I can finish this art card. I can maybe write in here. I could take perhaps one of our scribble flowers and I could paint those, as you've seen me do in the past with the distress paint, and I could put that in here. There's lots of different things that I could do. I could write around the perimeter. Again, this is just the beginning. It's a means to an end. It's just a chance to play and see how this works. But whether I said, whether you're using something like Ranger's texture paste, or you want to glob on some gel medium, again, this is also going to dry permanently clear. There's just lots of different ways that you can use these products to create some dimensional embellishments. Now, I will tell you one other thing that you can do, if I can put my hands on it and I don't see it. You can actually use liquid pearls. Now, the one thing that I will caution you, if you use liquid pearls and you glitter them, you can't make big dollops of the liquid pearls, because if you do, they kind of collapse on themselves as they dry. I'm sure, let me just grab a bottle. I'm sure it has something to do with the fact that the air can't get to the liquid pearl to have it dry like it normally would, because you're covering it and, you know, you're taking away the exposure to the air. So all you do is stick to smaller dots like this and don't expect perfect dots. Now, none of these colors actually work with this. This is Ballerina. It's a pale pink. Or actually, it's not even Ballerina. It's something else. It's an old color. But anyway, what you can do is just go ahead and drop this on here. And then you can just allow the glitter to stick to the liquid pearl. Now, I'm going to promise you that this will retain some dimension. How much is totally seems to be dependent. This is just one of those experimental things. It seems to be dependent on how much of the liquid pearl there is. The smaller the mound, the less collapsing. If you make a big mound, I can guarantee that it's going to collapse, and you'll get this kind of splodge of glitter. Now, that has its own benefits and effects as well, but if you want dimensional glitter effects, you can do that with very small amounts of liquid pearls. So lots of different ways that you can incorporate glitter. Whether you're a wild go-for-it glitter girl or you just like it a little bit more subtle, there's plenty of ways that you can enjoy using glitter in your art.